Hey guys, it's Dusty Nails again. Oh my god, guys, I shoot beginning to end. So now I'm just gonna show you me shaping this into almond shape from a previous square set. Like, I couldn't show you guys the one like the other nine fingers because we'll be here for ages. So I'm just gonna show you the pinky. So I'm just filing both sides equally on both sides. And I'm not going to touch the side too much. I'm only now going to focus on shaping the tip of the nail and trying to make it as narrow as possible because we are doing an almond shape. So just only focus on the very, like, the free edge of the nail. Only the tip you focus on. Don't go too much on the sides and don't worry about it because later on we will then file the sides like you're seeing me now. Because I'm now getting basically closer to that almond shape, now I'm going to focus on the sides, but I'm only doing that as the last step. And then once I've done that and I like how it looks from my point of view, I would then flip a finger over like you see I've done, and I'm now going to look at her point of view and basically like file shape of everything. I'm trying to get that tip more into an almond shape, trying to just finalize every any last touches to the nail. So I'm just going to show you how I do that, guys. I'm still focusing more on that free edge just to get that almond shape, because with that constant filing, it can turn into like a stiletto and it can look a bit more, you know, a bit funny. So we don't want that. So there you go, guys. You guys can see how perfect these look. Like, look at them, guys. Like, come on. This is my go-to combo in ensuring that there's no lifting. So I just add some acetone. That is an old bottle I just got from Nail Nails, I think. And then afterwards, I'll go in with my dehydrator from Nail Nails and just one of that. And once that's done, I'll go in with my primer from Mia Secrets. I'm based in the UK, London, and once upon a time, Mia Secrets was available to be purchased. But for some reason, it's not. But for now, my Mia Secret. And then I'll go in with my acid primer from Nail Nails. These are my go-to combo. And once that's done, I will then go in with a thin coat of clear acrylic, and that's going to help with basically lifting. It's going to help with lifting and just general protection of the nails, to be honest.
Yes, you just need a thin layer. I mostly use it's quite more watery, because when it's too, I don't want it too thick, so I sort of use like a watery consistency when I apply my protective layer. So just ensure that it's very, very thin, because it's only used for lifting purposes, based on my observation, lifting purposes. So yeah, I'm gonna use Nail Nails Warm Beige, and that'll be my core nude color. So you guys can check it out. It is very universal, and it fits all skin tone in my point of view. So you guys can see me going in trying to pick up my first bead, because it's a cuticle. Oh, that's clear. Oh my gosh. Sorry guys, I'm still on clear. Like, I'm trying to do this voiceover, guys. I'm still on clear. Okay, so you guys are gonna see me now going with my warm beige from Nail Nails. And I'm going to pick up my first bead. You don't need your first bead should not be like super duper big, because it's just an info. However, if you have a lot of lifting and you're feeling more near in the middle of the nails, where's the tip? And obviously you need more acrylic. But because I'm just filling the cuticle area, it's only been like about 3.5 weeks. I don't need that much acrylic. So you just see me get my first bead. Try not to make it too watery, and try not to make it too thick, because if you make it too thick, towards the cuticle will be like a massive hump, and you don't want that. So I'm just cleaning up the sidewall and just around the cuticle area, just making sure it's kind of flush and stuff like that, and making sure there's no acrylic on the skin, because if there's acrylic on the skin, that's gonna promote lifting. And when a nail lifts and water gets inside of it, then that becomes basically, it's like it's a environment for it, an environment for it to breed infections, and we don't want that. So let me here just tuck it in, finalizing some strokes, make sure everything is like it's in the right proportion, you know. I'm just gonna add another bead because the first bead, it was a bit light. I can still see old acrylic peek through. So this is a second bead just to build some sort of strength, and not only that, just to build some sort of thickness in the cuticle, but we don't want it to be overly thick anyways. So I'm gonna let you guys watch that until I get on to the second finger. Yeah, so this is my second finger now, the ring finger. So when it's my first bead, I'm trying to push it up towards the cuticle, trying to get it as close as possible, but still not trying to touch the cuticle. You can see me wiping the sides as well, just making sure that's not on the skin, because we don't want to cause any allergic reaction. Then again, you have to invest in your products, because the products that I use, they limit that dramatically. So I'm going to add another bead, try basically get as close to the cuticle. I like to I like to push the acrylic towards the cuticle. Like, I would apply the acrylic away from the cuticle at least a couple of inches, and I'll use my brush and then push the acrylic up closer to the cuticle, rather than applying the cuticle bead very close to the cuticle. Like, I hope that makes sense, guys. But that's basically what I like doing. And then now I'm just going to add a bit of acrylic in the middle and basically the tip, just to build strength. We don't want the tip to chip or to break because of lack of strength. So I'm going to apply some acrylic towards the tip and also the middle. And then now I'm just touching up, doing some finalizing, making sure that the cuticle is flush and also the rest of the nails looks very good. You can also look from, when you're doing the nails, look from side to side and up, and basically look from the tip upwards, because that's, you'll be able to see if there's any dips in the nail. You'll be able to see if you need to apply any more acrylic, and those are like little good little pointed tips to learn, because it's quite good. So I'm on to the next finger, guys. So I'm just gonna have a look. See, so just apply the bead and you push it up, you push it up, you push it up, you push it up very close, not touching the cuticle, and you brush down. And when you brush down or swipe down, is to blend. So now after I've swiped down, aka blending, now I'm just gonna go for a very, very tiny bead, a much more, like a bit closer to the cuticle. Make sure it's not touching too much, because I don't want any dips in the side of the cuticle, because most times you can put acrylic on the top, but then between the sides of the cuticle, they might not have much product, and I want to make sure there's much product. So I'm just adding an extra bit just to finalize it, make it look flush, make everything look very neat. And that's really it, to be honest. So I'll let you guys watch that.
Thank you. everywhere. Freaks and Harrys, dykes and fairies, tell me where it's empty. Tax the rich, feed the poor, till they are never rich no more.
Another thing I want to point out is that to keep your shape, you have to pat on the sides. Like when you apply your acrylic, pat on the sides, because with acrylic, it likes to float around. It likes to move while it's still wet. So you just take pat the sides, each side, just to keep that shape. Because the last thing you want to do is spend another 10 minutes shaping. Like there's no need for it once your shape is already good. So I'm going to get some more acrylic and I'm going to put it in the cuticle area. I'm going to push up. You can see me pushing right up. Push up. Make sure the fingers face down, like tilted downwards, so the acrylic can flow down rather than back into the cuticle. And you just blend down. You can see me blending, because I'm blending the acrylic I just applied that's still wet. And I'm going to blend it into the acrylic that I've already applied that's more of like more drying. I normally use my tip of my brush to really get into spaces, because with that tip, the tip of the brush is going to get into spaces that's very, very small. And I like to use the tip of my brush more for a cuticle, and then the middle of my brush and the bottom of my brush for like blending the middle and the free edge. You can see from the point of view, you see that nice little, it's risen a bit and it just looks and curves down. Like I don't have to explain it, but that's like how you want your shape, your nail to look, especially from the side view. You don't want any dips in your nail, any nothing. Like in the Caribbean we call it potholes. You don't want no potholes in your like in your nails. You don't want it. So yeah, so now I'm just file side to side. Make sure it's in proportion. This video I sped it up a little bit, like the most smallest bit, because I still want you guys to get the video. I don't want it to be too speeded up and you know you're missing things out. So this is it. You file side to side, you pull the skin back so you don't nip them, and you file side to side. Because I've already shaped and it is pre-shaped already, there's not much filing I need to do. It's just more of the sides, because when you put acrylic on, it naturally wants to float away. Like it wants to widen. Like I don't know how to make it make sense. But acrylic itself, when you put it on, it does, the nails does seem wider, because it always wants to float away. So just file the sides, take the sides in, push the skin back, and just focus on the sides, because the tip is already shaped and you don't want it to be a stiletto, because it won't look right. Just mostly focus on the side, get that straight, get it tucked in so it's not too wide on the corners. If you want to twist your client's hand, you twist it. In the meantime, just ask them that if it's painful or not. Otherwise than that, just do your thing, because at the end of the day, when it's all shaped nicely, they're gonna like it. Like they're gonna see and they're gonna like it. So just make sure that the shape is on point. So you can see on the thumb, I push the skin back. Sometimes I use my finger, sometimes I use my finger, sometimes I use the file. But just pull that skin back and file. But yeah, I'll let you guys watch that. So I'm just flipped her hand back, and I do this a lot because it really helps me, because from my point of view it may be okay, and from their point of view it might not. So I just flip it just to see from their point of view, to know what to adjust. And sometimes my point of view ain't looking right, and I'll put it I'll flip their hands around, and then I'm able to now really finessed the shape. So it works both ways. Some people might do it this way, but I do it both ways. This and my point of view works perfectly fine. So yeah,
The next clip is a very important clip that I want you guys to see, because I do this all the time and it almost guarantees no lifting, and it almost guarantees 100% sealing the cuticle. Like, so I'm gonna keep, like, just stay like a couple seconds and you guys gonna see it, because it's real legit. So this is it, guys. I use my hand to push back the cuticle and push it back. I used to use a cuticle pusher. Like, the first thing I would do is use one, but I wouldn't advise it. Use your hands and push back the cuticles first, and once you've pushed it back, you can use the cuticle pusher to really, you know, do its thing. Now, once you've done that, you would have seen the natural nail plate, just a bit of it, like you can see, and you would have seen where the acrylic starts. And then now you're going with your drill and you just seal the cuticle, like you seal it, and basically that. And while you're doing that, best believe it, guys, even the epinicium, that will get, some of it will get foul. Like, the part that has more of dead skin will get fouled away naturally with the foul. You know, back then I used to use the nippers, because in the UK it's legal to use the nippers. But now I'm thinking, nope, I ain't using it unless I have to. And she doesn't have much cuticles, so there's no need to use it, because when you're going with the hand file, the electric file, it's gonna basically do the work for you as well. I only use the nippers if someone hasn't done a nose in a long time and it really requires it. Otherwise, I will not use it. So yeah, that's my go-to. It works for me. Like, the minute I don't know how I did it, I don't know what made me do it, but I just did it, and ever since I did it, it's guaranteeing guarantees. If that makes sense. So I'm gonna let you guys watch that.
Parents, dykes and fairies, tell me where it's empty. Tax the rich, feed the poor, till there are never rich no more.
So guys, I literally forgot to record the pinky. Like, I thought I did, I literally thought I pressed play, but I didn't. So I'm just going to show you the other four fingers. This is me just doing from, what works for me is side to side. So this, back then I used to do like a V, then round, and do this, like a whole geometry work out on the nail just to get almost perfect fringe. But what works for me from sidewall to sidewall, like swoop, swoop, as long as you got the sidewall, that should be where you start and where you kind of keep in line. And then once I do the swoop, swoop, I then focus on the tip. And what also works with me, because I'm not the best at fringe, I'm only now becoming good, is brush. Brush tools, like, oh my gosh, I didn't know it was such, like, I didn't know it would make a difference, but it actually makes a difference. Like, it's so crazy. I didn't know it actually did, but it works. So if you get yourself a really, really good brush, I feel like it's going to do half of the work for you while you do the other half. But for French, sidewall to sidewall, that's the best I can say, like, how to explain it, because that's what works for me. And I feel like if you followed that, then you would be able to. So in this footage, I'm showing both hands because I hardly get a chance to do nail art. Like, I don't think I've done, like, a proper nail art on YouTube. I've never done this video before, like, a video like this. So I'm really proud of myself. I was able to video this, and majority of the hands stayed in the frame, because most times something will be out and that will ruin the whole, you know, the whole video. So everything is very much self-explanatory from here onwards, and very much repetitive. So have a look, continue to watch, guys. I do the French. I'm doing it on both hands so you guys can see, like, how I'm doing it. Everywhere, freaks and fairies, dykes and fairies, tell me where it's empty. Tax the rich, feed the poor, till there are never rich no more.
everywhere. Freaks and herons, dykes and fairies, tell me where it's empty. Tax the rich, feed the poor, till there are never rich no more.
Coming to an end, and if you guys made it this far, give me a love heart in the comments. Like, I really appreciate it. I'm just applying top coat from iGel. I got it from a beauty supply store, but I think they're closing down, so I don't know where I'm gonna get this top coat again, but from iGel, it's really amazing. So this is the finished look, guys. Like, I am loving it. Like, I'm loving how flush it looks. Like, I am so loving this. I'm so glad she came for a film. Like, this is it, guys. So continue watching. Make sure you like, comment, and subscribe. I intend to make videos like this. Like, if you guys like these long videos, let me know, and I will literally make it. Like, I'll make it happen. If you guys prefer to see the application and just the nail art, like, I don't mind. Let me know what you guys think and propose, like, something that I can do, and I will definitely do it. It was so nice to do this voiceover. It was so nice to show you guys my talent. Like, it was so nice to just record all of this. Like, I had so much fun recording.
Till there are never rich no more.
going with that Senior's cuticle. If you guys would like one, just put me a comment or DM me on Instagram at Delcie Nails. Now, this is the finished look. I like it, she like it, and I hope you guys like it.